Yeah? What's that? Spider-Man! Oh! Did you have an adventure? Oh, you almost gave Daddy a heart attack. Oh, yes, you did. Oh, yes, you did. Good work, other Spider-Man. Thanks.
Yeah. Of course. Hey, man. Any leads on who our cat thieves were working for?
I'm chasing down a couple of problems that might be connected. Robberies on Harlem's commercial strip, and something going down at Feast North. I'll post in the app when I know more.
Cool. Thanks, dude.
Miles, we still meeting today? Never got a text back from you.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Been wrapped up in my own stuff. But I'm free now. Where?
Sweet. 78th and West End.
78th?
Hey, it's Paris. And thank you so much for checking out my hands-on impressions and first look at Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales for the PlayStation 5. Now, I want to thank PlayStation. They sent over a review code for Miles Morales as well as provided the PlayStation 5 hardware where I had all my hands-on impressions of the game. Now, I'm not going to spoil anything. No story spoilers here, no character reveals, none of that. I kind of just want to have a conversation about the game. I'm sure you're going to see many impressions and reviews of Miles Morales, so I just want to have a casual conversation this time. And maybe once the game is actually out and everyone has had a chance to actually play the game and experience the story, do like kind of a spoiler review or something like that. I'm actually kind of thinking Danny and myself may do something like that in the near future. But for now, this is just going to be my overall impressions of not only the game, but the game running on the PlayStation 5. So, like I said, no spoilers here, but the first thing I want to say is I loved it. I did. I really loved it. I was a huge fan of Spider-Man on the PlayStation 4, and while this isn't a true sequel to that game, it's more of a continuation, we're now getting it from Miles' point of view. We're seeing the Miles Morales story that lives inside that actual PlayStation 4 Spider-Man game, and I thought it was great. The length of it was good. That was an early concern of mine, that this would just be almost like a glorified expansion pack, but, you know, I got a solid 10 hours out of this by the time I actually completed the main story. And, you know, I think even if I would have just rushed through it completely, probably around 8. So let's just say a good 8 to 10 hours would be the actual story campaign here in Miles Morales. It took me, you know, like I said, over 10, maybe even closer to 11 hours to complete it because I was doing a lot of the side mission stuff. You have side missions, you have crimes in progress, you have like underground caches that you can chase to get some of your tech points and things, as well as there's like these time caches. Like, so there's definitely some loot type things to chase in the game that can actually fill in the gaps as far as time goes. But I'll just say for the game itself again, that open world in New York is just freaking beautiful on the PlayStation 5. It really is. So playing this on the PlayStation 5, there's two modes that you can do it in. There's the actual dynamic 4K, 30 frames per second, ray tracing mode, just the visual fidelity mode, drop dead gorgeous playing in that. The ray tracing that you have as you're swinging through New York, the sun starting to set, the snow effects, drop dead gorgeous. You are going to love it. It is a visual feast playing it in that mode. Now, you can also play this in a performance mode, which allows you to play it at 60 frames per second. And I'm actually conflicted when it comes to that because I see the benefits of both. Now, when you're playing it at 60 frames, you're not going to get the visual showcase. It's still at 4K, but some of the bells and whistles have been turned off. You're not going to get ray tracing as an example, but it is just so buttery smooth while you're swinging through New York, or even some of the combat beats that you'll have at 60 frames, that it is definitely an option. I would suggest everyone to at least check out when you play this on the PlayStation 5. Now, I will tell you, ultimately, I played this the majority at 30 frames per second, and it was fine. Again, I just think it was such a visual showcase that was the way I preferred to play, but I am happy that PlayStation actually has those two options so you can bounce back and forth between the two and make up your own mind on what you think works for you. Now, the combat itself, again, going back to the original Spider-Man game on the PlayStation 4, you will be able to upgrade Miles as you go through. There are skill points you can do, obviously new moves you can upgrade your suits. Obviously, we've already seen the Into the Spider-Verse suit. I won't spoil anything, but that is one that is out there, and there's other suits that you can obviously get as you go through the game as well. Now, any of the footage that you actually will see in this review, this will all be from early in the game. I promise you, I'm not going to spoil anything other than to say, going back to the combat, it's really good. Really, really good. I had a lot of fun with the combat. Now, the difference between Peter and Miles is Miles now has his Venom attacks because, you know, he charges up with electricity. And as you upgrade Miles, you'll be able to chain together different type of combos and attacks, and it works really well. Miles also has his camouflage mode, which you can upgrade through the skill tree as well. And that can make your combat very stealth and very tactical in the way you approach certain things. So that's another good thing to do. And that's something that separates it from the first game, which, again, this isn't a spoiler, but Peter Parker is in the game, but now he's a side character. He's more of a mentor to Miles because Miles is still learning to be Spider-Man. When we pick up with his story, he's not as silky smooth and perfect as Peter is, you know, swinging through the city or with the combat, any of these things. And I think that's what separates it the most and gives it its own personality, because we're doing this from Miles's point of view. There's a sense of discovery there with Miles, and I really loved it. Now, being an African-American myself, and Miles, the character, being an Afro-Latino in New York, you know, you really get to see the story from that point of view. And there's some scenes where, you know, he's walking through Harlem and all that. You can kind of just get that atmosphere and that vibe of being Miles Morales, being this young teenage superhero and everything that goes with it. You know, his struggle and his sense of duty, of wanting to be a hero, live up to the Spider-Man name, all of that. And again, I say this a million times, but I don't want to spoil it, but absolutely, when you're in the story, you're going to see what I mean, and you're going to understand what I mean by all this. So, like I said, overall, fantastic game. It really is. Drop Dead Gorgeous to play, you know, in the fidelity mode with ray tracing on the PlayStation 5. Now, the DualSense controller, I guess I didn't bring that up. Two things, the DualSense and the Pulse Wave headset, the 3D headset, which actually, since I have both here, that headset and in DualSense here. Now, with the DualSense, it does take some advantage of the haptic feedback that you'll have with this new DualSense controller. You'll really kind of feel it as you're playing while you're in combat. Your Spidey sense goes off, things like that. So I think Insomniac, for a first pass as a launch game, did a really great job integrating some of the DualSense features into Miles Morales. And then, like I said, with this headset, the 3D audio, fantastic. This has been the way I've played the entire game, and you're really just hearing the sounds of New York City and just the atmosphere of everything that's going on. It's really, really good. So if you get a chance to pick up that 3D headset, absolutely take advantage of that and play it that way. Or if there's a third-party headset that also takes advantage of the 3D audio, highly suggest you check that out as well. But again, overall, I have not seen the PlayStation 4 version, so I cannot comment on that. I think when Danny and I get a chance to sit down and talk about the game, maybe we can kind of talk about the PlayStation 4 version of the game versus the PlayStation 5 and any differences that we see. But for me, loved it. Absolutely loved it. And I'll fully admit, I didn't go into this thinking I would. I didn't know. I like I said earlier, I thought, this is just going to be a glorified expansion, but Insomniac absolutely knocked this out of the park. I mean, if you've seen that Into the Spider-Verse movie, just think of that and think of a young Miles Morales first becoming Spider-Man and everything that goes with it. And it's great. The music soundtrack in this, fantastic as well. I had a blast. I really did. I can't wait to jump back in and to keep playing, because that's the other thing. Just being in that open world of New York as Spider-Man, and you, as I was playing through the game, at certain points, I'm like, my God, am I actually playing is this a comic book movie, or am I playing a video game? It was that good. It really captured the vibe of Spider-Man, of the Marvel Universe, just everything that goes with it. And like I say again, I'm not going to spoil anything. Experience the story for yourself. experience all the surprise character reveals that you'll see in there. It's really, really good. Insomniac has done an amazing job with this game. I tip my cap to them. You know, so if you're picking up a PlayStation 5 at launch, I highly suggest that you go pick up Spider-Man Miles Morales and experience this game. It is great. So with that said, we'll have more to talk about Spider-Man in the near future. We'll jump into some of the spoilers that surround this game. I think you guys are going to love it. I really do. So I don't want to ramble. Like I said, just want to have a conversation about Spider-Man. It was a very nice surprise, and it will be, in my opinion, probably the flagship launch title for the PlayStation 5. You guys are going to enjoy it, and I'll be curious to see when people pick this up on the PlayStation 4. I'll be curious to see how it plays on that as well. So until then, this has been my first look at Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales for the PlayStation 5. I'm Paris. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. Like, sub, all that stuff you do on YouTube. I'd really appreciate it. And until the next time, I will see you soon.
Yeah, I got it.
Come on, we're gonna be late. Hey! Dude, I am so filling your suit with snow. Are you still wearing your suit?
Yeah, you know, just in case.
It's gonna be fine. See, this is my favorite part of living in Harlem. Pop-up street fair, best food in the city, awesome music.
Yeah, this is pretty cool.
What do you think about Rio Morales? You gonna vote for
it? Still hard to think of Mom as a politician. She's been a teacher my whole life.
Similar skill sets, right? Corralling people.
That looks really cool.
You're welcome. Oh. Sorry.
I should take ASL with you next semester. I've basically already mastered Espanol.
Ah, see? Desde cuando?
Honey, I think you're worrying too much.
Gloria! Hey!
Hi, Miles. This is my girlfriend, Steph. She just started volunteering at Feast.
Good to meet you. I'm sure we'll run into each other at the shelter.
Speaking of,
no shifts for you till after winter break. If we're open by then.
What do you mean?
Don't worry about it. Enjoy your mom's speech. I'll call you after break.
Sweet kid. You want to head down to the rally?
Sure.
I'm at the nearly completed Roxxon Plaza, where city council candidates deal.
Underground tag. What do you think they'll do next?
Hopefully, realize fighting Spider-Man is too much trouble and decide to go home.
If only.